understand the true value of attachment? Do you think you understand the true value of attachment when you talk to someone all night long? Or you think you understand the true value of attachment when you miss someone the rest of the day? I say no. You understand the true value of attachment when you sit in your office one fine day. You get a mail from the HR department with the title increment letter, and the moment you click the mail, you find attachment missing. That is the day you understand the true value of attachment. And this happens in key this time. As the appraisal season got over, I got a mail from the HR department with attachment missing. Furious and nervous I became, I rushed to the HR department. But I saw outside the office there were celebrations happening. As a person who cannot control himself whenever he sees celebrations, I rushed outside the office to find that my boss had bought a swanky new BMW. And he stood there, sanguine, like a hunter who had just hunted his prey near his BMW. The moment he saw me, he called me, "Come, Dipankar, come here." I went near him. He gave a look, same look which Krishna gave to Arjuna during the battle of Kurukshetra, as if he was going to deliver the Gita to me. I folded my hands in front of him, thinking that I will get the elixir of corporate life. And then he started giving me lessons. "Dipankar, do you want to be successful in life?" I said, "Yes, sir." "Do you want to know how to be successful in corporate life?" I said, "Yes, sir." And he said, "If you keep working all the weekends this year." "Yes, sir." "If you do not take any holidays and vacations, even in Holi and Diwali." "Yes, sir." "If you work late hours in the office." "Yes, sir." Then what?" "Then what? I will buy the higher version of BMW next year." I got frustrated, depressed, dejected. But I remember, I have a better purpose to go. I have to rush to the HR department. After finishing this audio, I rushed to the HR department. People who work in corporate know, whenever you enter the HR department, there is a different aura there. The moment I entered, I saw my HR, tall, dark, handsome, but a pound of fat around his belly. And we lovingly called him Yamuna because of his beautiful smile he had. I went to him, rushed to him, with the same look Sunny Deol had in color, I charged him. "Where is my attachment?" He said to me, "Don't look after attachment. Don't follow attachment. You have no attachments, Dipankar." I said, "Why?" "Because this year you have no increment." Listening to this, my heart got further sullen. I asked him, "Why do you think so? I do not have increment this year." I became very angry. He gave the same Yamraj smile and said, "I will ask you some questions. Answer them first." "Okay, ask me." And he started, "How many days are in a year?" I said, "Why is he asking this? He wants to know my general knowledge." Still I answered, 365. Then he said, "How many hours are there in a day?" I said, 24. Then he said, "How many hours do you work, Dipankar, in a day?" Confused as I was, but my math is strong. So I immediately replied, 8. Then he asked, "What is 8 fraction of 24? I answered, 1/3. That point of time, he immediately looked at me, smiled and said, "You work only 1/3 of 365 days, and that is?" I thought for a while, and I said, "Okay, Yamraj, you feel that I work for only 122 days? He said, "No, Dipankar. You did not work for weekends, so just subtract the weekends. So 52 Sundays and 52 Saturdays just went off. And out of 122, I had to subtract 104. Still I had some desires in my heart. I said, I worked for 18 days. He said, no, you are very optimistic. You took 2 weeks sick leave. I still was optimistic. I removed 14 days from 18. Still 4 days were left. So I pleaded in front of him, Yamraj, did I work 4 days? He smiled at me, no. You did not come for Independence Day, Republic Day, New Year's Day, and Holi. So how many days you worked for? I gave him a beautiful look. And I said, I did not work for a single day the last year. I folded in front of him, apologized that I was stealing the company's money a whole year and I do not deserve any increment. He laughed at me. You are a very smart guy. Go back and enjoy your day. Since you are not working, just sit in your office. I came back to my office. I thought, there is no way you can outsmart your boss, neither your HR. I realized that day, HR is not doing this job. HR is high risk. That is the reason I should not have ventured to high risk area. As corporates, we find increments, bonus, appraisals as the individual part of it. But we forget that this is just momentary benefits of a 9-to-5 job. What is most important is experience. And as we garner experience year after year, we can challenge the Yamraj sitting in any high-risk area that we have the experience. And experience is what you have earned for the 365 days. Madam Postmaster.